What's going on, guys? Ultra Anastasio here with FlightPath.com. Now I have a first look video today of some new products. We have some new filters from Freewell Gear, as well as from PGY Tech sent me a bunch of things. We have the filter from PGY Tech, as well as a gimbal protector, and I'm excited about this one, really, for the pocket. And also I have a few skins from PGY Tech that they sent me. I normally don't put skins on my drones or devices or anything, so if you guys are interested in something like this, I will be giving these away, so make sure you guys stay tuned. And if you guys are new, I do a lot of drone tech tips, tutorials, and product reviews on this channel. So if that's something that interests you, please consider subscribing and also hitting that bell to be notified when I post new videos. And let's jump right into it, guys. So PGY Tech and Freewell Gear, they've actually have accessories for multiple drones. So if you guys are new to my channel, I've done a lot of reviews on Freewell as well as PGY Tech. They do a lot of filters, accessories for all the Mavics, the Phantom series drones. So I'm very familiar with their products and they're all very high quality products. And right now they've come out recently with some new ones. Now this is of course for the Osmo Pocket. I'll be doing more detailed videos of each one of these as I use them this week. So this video is really just a quick first look at some of these new products that are coming out. My first thoughts on them, and of course I'm gonna install them real quick onto the Osmo Pocket. Now Freewell Gear and PGY Tech sent me these, and this is the Freewell Gear set. This is an 8-pack, and it has everything from an ND4, an ND8, ND16, and a circular polarizer filter, as well as the hybrid ones. So Freewell has those hybrid ones where you're able to have an ND as well as a polarizer in one lens. This has the ND8, PL, ND16 PL, ND32 PL, as well as a darker ND64 with polarizer. We have PGY Tech, which has a 4-pack. This is an ND8 PL, ND16, ND32, and ND64 PL. So these are also hybrid filters or the dual filters that have both neutral density as well as polarized lens on these filters. Now the reason you have ND filters is really to adjust and dial in your exposure as far as shutter speed goes. So in order for you to get a real natural motion in your video, you want to be able to dial those exposure values in precisely, and to do that you're going to need something like ND filters. Now the one thing, if you don't have ND filters and you're shooting in bright daylight, what happens is that your shutter speed has to go really, really fast in order for you to compensate and make the exposure correct for your video. But the thing is, what happens with fast shutter is that you might get some jittery motion in it because it's capturing everything really, really fast as far as the shutter goes. So I know it's a lot of information. I just want to walk you guys through exactly what I mean. Here we're shooting in auto mode at 4K at 60 frames a second, which I think a lot of people will be shooting at. But if we freeze the video right here, you can actually see his arms actually look like they're still, like they're not moving. And that's because the shutter speed is so fast in auto mode on a sunny day that it's capturing no movement or no motion in those arms because the shutter is so fast. So of course, when you play that back, you just have a lot of frames lined up together that are really sharp and crisp. Now we want to be able to add a little bit of motion blur in this video because that's really what the eye sees. When there's motion, there should be a little bit of motion blur in the video. Right now we're still shooting at 4K at 60, and for us to get the highest quality image, we want to bring that ISO as low as possible because it is a sunny day. Let's keep it at ISO 100. Now if we're going to use the 180 degree rule, basically what it means is that if you're shooting at something like 60 frames a second, you're going to want to double your shutter speed to about 120. So here we have it set at 120. We're shooting at 4K at 60. Now let's play this back. So now that we've switched it from auto to manual, we have full control over the exposure settings. Now we've initially put it here at ISO 100. We've slowed that shutter speed down to 1/120th. And now if you freeze frame it, you're able to see a little bit of motion blur in those arms. And that motion is exactly what we want because that feels more natural to the eye. If we didn't have any motion blur, everything would look too sharp and too crisp. We want to add that little bit of motion blur. Now let's go ahead and correct the exposure with some ND filters. Now to choose the right ND filter, what you want to do is go through your set, and you'll start getting used to this as you understand the strengths and how they work. But of course, the higher number it is, the darker the strength of the ND is. I chose here an ND8, and with an ND8, it feels like it was pretty good as far as the exposure goes. Here's what the video looks like now with an ND8 filter shooting the exact same sunlight. If we freeze frame it here, our exposure looks correct. We have natural motion blur in the arms, which is exactly what we want. I'd say an ND8 for the situation worked out the best.
Now let's bring it back and put it side by side. As you can see on the left-hand side, it is in auto mode. It is a little bit overexposed, and the camera is determining the exposure. So the shutter speed is very high, which means every frame is very sharp. Not as natural as what we want it to be. On the right, we took control, and this is about 8 minutes later, as you can tell by the shade coming through, but our subject is still in direct sunlight. Manual mode, ND8 filter, shutter at 1/20th, and we have that natural blur in there. Now let's go back and I'll show you exactly what comes in these kits from FreeWheel and from PGY Tech.
And as you can see, we have all 8 filters, and they sit nicely in this little case right here. We have the ND filters here up top, and then we have the ND plus polarizer here at the bottom. Comes in this really nice traveling case for you to keep it protected and easily removed from the case just like that, with these little finger holes here on the side of each one of them. Next, we have the PGY Tech filter set. This is a 4-pack, and it also has a hard plastic case for traveling. And what's really cool about this one is that this set actually sits on top. Now the filters are a little bit easier to grab than the FreeWheel gear from this case. The FreeWheel actually sits deeper in a foam. This one is really on the top right here, and it's held in by magnets. So on the back of each one of these filters is actually a magnet, and the magnet is what holds it on place in front of the lens on your Osmo Pocket. So this one is nice because it's just a magnet holder, and you can stick it here on top and it'll just stick to the back of this plastic piece right here with magnets. It's a little bit easier to grab as far as trying to access these filters. Now to install the filters, this is actually a first time for DJI because they're using magnets instead of like a screw thread or a thread that normally goes around, or even something that covers it. You know, so if you remember the Spark, they had that whole like hinge system here that holds on to the camera. And if you are used to something like the Phantom or even the Mavic, it has the screw on the front. This one's different because there is no seam. There's nothing on the front of the Osmo Pocket. So I was kind of curious on how it sits in there. But if you look at the filter itself, there is a magnet that's on the very back of each one of these filters. And all you have to do is place it right on top of the lens. Make sure it's perfectly centered. And there's a little groove on the inside of the lens, so it kind of just sits in there really easy. So this is probably the easiest filter set that you're gonna be able to install on a camera. And I tested out both of these filters on them. Powering up was fine. No issues as far as balancing goes. It didn't feel like there was any strain or any additional, you know, weight that was making the gimbal sag or anything like that. So weight-wise, everything felt fine on each one of these filters. Now the PGY Tech one seems to be a little bit deeper, or a deeper set as far as the filter goes. So it's a little bit taller, but weight-wise, everything, as you can see here, seems to balance out just fine. I didn't see any issues as far as the edges go, because this one is a little bit taller than the FreeWheel ones. But when I look at the video, I'm not seeing anything. It's not coming into the shot or anything like that. So everything seems to be balanced fine. And I was able to test out both on the slow pan as well as the fast follow pan, and everything seems to work and function as normal. Now the one product I was excited about was this one, which is the gimbal protector for the Osmo Pocket. And if you guys haven't seen my first video as far as my review video on the Osmo, I did talk about the holder on here and how I was kind of frustrated with why is this strap on here and not on the camera, as well as, you know, having to carry this around. And when I was shooting with it and really testing out the Osmo Pocket, majority of the time I didn't have it in its holder. I just wanted to keep this in my pocket by itself because of just that hassle of taking it out. I know it protects it, and I know it's, you know, definitely beneficial for it when you're in transit. But if you just want to shoot and kind of put it away real quick, to have to pull this out and then put it back in, you know, like that, and then put that, strap it on and then put it in your pocket. It just, you know, anytime you can like eliminate a step, makes things a lot easier. So the one thing I actually was thinking about when I saw this was a way for you just to protect the gimbal itself, because I think everything else on the pocket is really well built. You know, the screen and just the, you know, the build quality of the handle itself feels really strong. So the only thing that's fragile on this thing is that gimbal. So it was nice to see that PGY Tech already thought of that and made a gimbal protector to hold the camera and gimbal in place while you're traveling with it. So it makes it a little bit easier for you just to kind of stick it in your pocket. And it just goes on by pressure on both sides. And it's even, you know, form fitting here at the bottom to fit right over the lens, right over the handle. And once you put it on, it's just, you know, really on there by pressure, but no issues as far as it coming off. And it's nice just like this because you can just put that on and then throw this in your pocket. And at least you know that your gimbal is not going to snap off if you bend over or if you're moving around or if your pocket or if your jacket pocket or something is swinging and it hits something. At least you know that your gimbal is protected, which of course is the most important piece. So nice that they made a gimbal protector for the Osmo Pocket. And I'm not even sure if DJI is releasing one of these, you know, anything else besides just this. So this for me was a big deal. But the one thing I did realize when I was playing around with it was once you take it off, which is kind of cool, I know it's not made for it, so disclaimer, don't get mad at me if you break it, but it actually kind of fits this way. So once you take it off here, what I did was just placed it here, and just by a little bit of the pressure, it's able just to kind of sit there at the bottom of your camera, which is kind of cool. So at least I know I'm not gonna lose it when I'm using it. So what I did was just, you know, take it off from here. So here it is, it's on there right now. What I did was take this off, pop it here at the bottom. Like I said, it's not meant for it, so don't get mad if it breaks over, you know, in the long run. But I just left it there, and what I saw was kind of cool. It worked that you can kind of use it as like a little mini stand. So not made for it, don't get mad, but this is kind of what I'm doing with it. And there you go. So it's like a little mini stand in a way too. And there it is, the PGY Tech Gimbal Protector for your Osmo Pocket. I think this definitely is a must have. And as always guys, links are gonna be down below in the description for these products. And PGY Tech also sent me these skins. Now I don't normally put skins on my drones or on my cameras, but really cool just to have a unique camera or a unique drone. PGY Tech has these little wraps or skins that you can put to decorate your Osmo Pocket. So of course I'll be giving these away to you guys. If you guys want to, you know, want to make your Osmo Pocket a little bit different, if you have one, just leave me a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite feature of the Osmo Pocket is. Leave that in the comments section down below. I will pick a random winner from the comments. Let me know what you guys, what's your favorite feature of this new Osmo Pocket, and I'll make sure I pick a winner within the next few days from those comments down below. And like I said, I'll be doing more videos about these filters later, but if you wanna get a jump on just understanding a little bit more, I have a ton of other videos on it. They're more drone related, but the concept is exactly the same. What filters do, how they work, how to properly expose for your video, how to install them. All those videos are gonna be in that playlist, so make sure you guys check that out. As always, if you guys got value from my video, don't forget to hit that like button, and also don't forget to subscribe. Hit that bell to be notified when I post new videos. This is Ultra Stasio with FlightPath.com. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.